Hello, I'm Elizabeth Barry, and I'm reminding you to get out of your own way and to step into your greatness, into your strength, into your confidence and courage, and live the life fulfilled. I recently wrote a new book called The Kind Communicator. It's about soft skills being the future of business, being the future of life, how we communicate healthily, how we effectively and clearly communicate with one another and with self. Is truly one of the most important factors. Every breakdown is a breakdown in communication. And we find that we find that we don't put up the right boundaries. We find that we're saying the wrong things and they're not landing the way we wish them for them to land, because either we're saying the wrong things or our approach is completely off. So what I'm doing is I'm hosting workshops based on my book, The Kind Communicator, across the United States. And I'm doing it at schools, universities, at small businesses, at medium to large businesses, corporations, corporate events, women's organizations, you name it, I will be there. So if you are interested in the book, you can find it on Amazon, Kindle, and iBooks. My website is Elizabeth Barry Consulting. But at some of these workshops, I'm asking attendees to arrive and anonymously put down something that is currently holding them back in life in terms of communication right now. And I was providing some feedback and insight on how to do that. So at my last event, I had attendees put down some of the thoughts that are hindering their communication. And this new video series is dedicated to them. This particular person wrote, "I'm having trouble working through my feelings of responsibility for the breakup of a long-term relationship." That's tough, but it's not as tough as you think it should be, right? So the first thing is to recognize that when you're working through feelings of anything, compassion and empathy for self, self-reflection is really a wise thing to start with. Think about everything from a whole. When I wrote my book, Own Your Vulnerability, I really had to sit in the quiet. Sit in the quiet for a little while and think about why you're going through these feelings. Why are these feelings there? Where did they come from? Where did they stem from? What is the history of them? And are they hindering you? Are they hurting you? Are they holding you back from something in your life? So take that quiet time for yourself to reflect, become vulnerable, and don't fight those weaknesses that you might be having in working through those feelings, and give yourself some time. You know, this sort of breakup of a long-term relationship, you use the word responsibility here, which is huge. I'll get to that. But really, this stuff takes time to heal. And time is a wonderful healer, although we want things to happen quickly and overnight, and it often doesn't happen that way. But I find that the more self-reflection and the quiet time that we have, the quicker things happen, the quicker results we get, the more ideas come to our minds quicker when we are reflective of why are we going through these feelings in the first place. So it's a part of self-care, it's a part of self-love. Whether you're a man or a woman, you can practice self-care and self-love. It's a very important time to do that if you're in your 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s. They didn't teach this stuff in school. It's not all about the fucking bubble bath. It's not all about the self-help books. It's really about quiet time with self and loving yourself for who you are, loving your weaknesses, owning your strengths, and being fully aware of the balance between holding that vulnerability of weakness and strength and just being okay with it. Right? Honoring your time, honoring what you received from this relationship. When you're working through any feelings of a breakup of a long-term relationship, you should honor what that relationship has given you, right? So I think that the biggest thing is when we are breaking up with someone, we have to remember what that person has given to us. And sometimes it's not all good things, right? But sometimes the bad things are the lessons. Every teachers come in many faces and forms and many times in our life. Everyone that we meet in our lives is a teacher. If you can think about this relationship as a teacher for you, for yourself, what did you get? What did you learn about yourself? What's What are the bad things that you learn that maybe you allow things to happen? Maybe you don't put up enough boundaries. Maybe you don't communicate about boundaries. And maybe you are easily manipulated. Maybe you manipulate others. Maybe you are using the word responsibility here because you feel guilty. You feel resentment. You feel like you shouldn't have done something. But own that. Time, quiet, self-reflection, self-love, owning that responsibility and honor what you've received. And the more bad things that you can like write down or think about, it's okay that they're bad because every person is a lesson for us to understand who we are. We have one life in this body on this planet. And the more you can look at yourself or the stuff that you're not so good at and use that as a lesson and not only... what I mean by use it as a lesson is that if you cannot, we don't learn just by having lessons, right? You have to apply the lesson. Unless, and if you don't apply the lesson, it's gonna, the mistake is gonna happen over and over and over. That's allowing. That's knowing that there's a lesson and it's, applying it means communicating how you feel, communicating a boundary, and respecting and honoring and allowing yourself to move forward instead of moving backward, right? So the word responsibility here was really interesting to me. I want you to think about responsibility. Responsibility is hard. but it's also cool. As an adult, when we take responsibility for what we've gained, what we've learned, what we've allowed for the time in a relationship, we have to take the responsibility and own that time, own the things that we've said and done, and maybe work through that. What are you feeling responsible for? Maybe take some time to answer that question wholeheartedly. What are you working through my feelings of responsibility, what are you responsible for? What do you feel like you're responsible for? Because that sounds like to me that it's like a parent thing, like a parent is responsible for a kid. You feel like you've done something or you have to do something, you have to nurture. Also with responsibility and breaking up, they wrote a song about it. Breaking up is hard to do. It's really difficult. It's like the song, breaking up is really difficult, but sometimes I think that breakups are needed. When we discover that we're not right for someone, the worst thing that we can do is to allow it to continue. Allowing something to continue that is toxic or negative or holding us back from something is not going to allow the energy to flow into your soul. It has this weight. It's very weighted. It's very heavy. And for staying in a long-term relationship that is not right for you, which you know, you might have come to this conclusion that, oh man, I don't want to be here anymore and I feel responsible for that, then be okay with that. But understand that the more that you allow yourself to be in that situation, the harder it's going to be to breathe, to smile, to live authentically, free. I was a culprit of this too. I stayed in something that was that I should have left long ago. But the biggest lesson that I learned was finally just walking away because I honored the relationship for what it showed me, and now I have a whole brand based on ego because of what I learned in my relationship and what I allowed. I was a person who allowed things to happen, and I won't do that anymore. I've become stronger. I've become wiser. I communicate how I feel, what my desires are in an empathetic and compassionate way, and it makes me a better lover. It makes me a better relationship partner for someone. And think about what's on the opposite side of this. Smile, breath, freedom. And as you work through those feelings of responsibility for this long-term relationship, I want you to love yourself, love the relationship for what it was. And if you truly know that this isn't for you, the best thing is to break the ties, because otherwise that little tethered piece, that little tethered yarn can really, it can be tense and it can really hold us back and keep us connected to something in the past. And what I find in my teaching and in my life is that I want to be present and I want to be the best that I am here. And I'm not hindered from the past. I don't want to be, and I don't want you to be hindered from the past either. So stop hanging on to the past, man. Live your life for yourself, love yourself, and step into the greatness of what is coming next if you choose to do so. Long-term relationships are life lessons for us, and everyone that we come into a relationship with in life is a teacher. So what did you learn, and what can you take with you to apply now that you've learned this? I hope this helps. I hope you have a beautiful day. My name is Elizabeth Barry. You can find me at elizabethbarryconsulting.com. Be kind to you.